My careers master, Mr. Baskerby, said, Craig Jordan is an unusual young man.
I saw that he was a unique individual.
Capital letters. A very unusual young man.
He really understands the potential in people, where other people don't.
They said we had to learn what that meant. The rest is history. My name is Dr. V. Craig Jordan. I'm the living legend professor at the MD Anderson Cancer Center. Most of the ground was laid when I was at grammar school before the age of 18. After my father had bought me a chemistry set one Christmas, I decided I wanted to convert my bedroom into a real chemistry laboratory. Now I wanted to learn more and more chemistry. It was as easy as that. I focused all my career over the last 40 years in the discovery that we can use failed contraceptives that were available, but they weren't going anywhere. And I wanted to turn them into anti-cancer agents for the treatment and prevention of breast cancer. How bad was it? They couldn't find anybody in the whole country who would be willing to examine my PhD because it was useless. One person, Dr. Arthur Walpole, at a pharmaceutical company with a failed contraceptive that became tamoxifen that they didn't know what to do with, agreed to be my examiner. The discovery of what became SERMs, selective estrogen receptor modulators, all happened by accident. We did an experiment because a man came from another department and he said, we know estrogen is good for bones, but I want you to develop a model for me in rats of using anti-estrogens that makes bones rot away. And we treated them with tamoxifen, but we did the first experiment. So he treated the animals for 3 months, gave me the results, and I said, are you sure you've not mixed up all of these groups? This can't be true. Tamoxifen maintained bone density just like estrogen. One compound can maintain bone density, decrease heart attacks, prevent osteoporosis, decrease breast cancer, stop it nearly dead in its tracks. So scientifically, we have been given the credit for that with prizes around the world.
The environment in Dr. Jordan's lab was actually very exciting because we were doing groundbreaking work in those days.
Tamoxifen team is a family. So you can go to all of the people in the tamoxifen team. I have a newsletter and I put that out probably every other month and send it around to probably the 50 or 60 people that are part of this group.
I was lucky because Dr. Jordan realized my potential and saw that I could be a great scientist.
My mentor, the Nobel laureate Sir James Black, said to me, invest in the young. That was his most important thing. That's what I do. I invest in the young by investing in making sure they get the best degrees that they can.
I've had a lot of mentors during my career, but Dr. Jordan really stands above all the others because he really has made me what I am today. What I learned from Dr. Jordan is to really realize that serendipity that occurs, that when experiments don't occur the way you think that they're gonna do, that's where the real discoveries come.
Serendipity, if I hadn't been asked to make this new model of osteoporosis, we wouldn't have any of this. If I'd have stayed in Britain, we wouldn't have any of this. So there's some magic hand guiding all of this. We may call it God or fate or serendipity.